little bit short. So the clock is stopped at 5 minutes 15 seconds to go. More importantly, we have got a third and a long hit to win here. They seek to convert just inside Jordan's territory at the 37-yard line. There's a step back to Lopez. He gives it back to Rogers, trying to give Rogers the block. You can hear the roar of approval there from Chris Chamberlain, number 35, the defending end of that one. And that's actually going to be a loss of about 4 yards. And so with Harold, Bill Harold, what you would think would be a punting situation as the ball is inside their territory now at their own 39-yard line. Remember, of course, in six-man football, the 40 is the lead of the strike. So the ball's at the 39, and indeed, they are going into a punting formation. No one's back to receive the flag. There's the kick. The kick over in, heading towards the left sideline, and it goes well out of bounds. Let's see what they mark it. They're going to mark it at the 25-yard line. So that punt, actually, they're going to mark it at the 47-yard line. So that punt carries 14 yards. And so they score the Longhorns defense, has risen to the occasion, has given the ball back to their offensive unit in pretty good field position at the 28. You know, Luke, one interesting part about these offenses, they work a lot of different phases. You get the football, look around, a lot of waiting, there's a lot of hearing going on, and really a lot of things happen just because they happen to not be playing that way. So C11 and C5 in the backfield. There's a handoff around the right side. 11, he's got some room, breaks out of one tackle at the 35, and falls forward to the 38-yard line. Sort of an inside reverse, but down to 9 yards, it's 11. So they're going to mark him at about the 37-yard line and pick up with about 10. And so Gordon seems to be perhaps getting rid of a few of those jitters. As we have one of the ESPN cameramen out on the field right now, and he's pushing to back away from Cody Delvin Campbell. They're trying to focus on the football game. Second and 5, so C and the sign formation have Jesus Saw Marina signed toward the backfield. Gets back to sign for him. Has the room, but his ankle tackled at about the 40. Really hefty. Real estate down the right sideline. If you could have gotten past one of the Whitfield Panthers, I believe that's number 12, Brandon Rogers, who had a great tackle. Could have been a touchdown saving tackle, because we have seen sign for him down the sideline very quickly before. An incredible athlete to win all your balls. And the Gordon Longhorns do have a lot of weapons, 11 sizemore property. I'll tell you what, sizemore is the bread and butter. Third and a long three. There's a handoff, 11 up the middle. He has to move it down and go. Wow. 265 pounds. That's a large man. I think that just hurts some loose balls out there. I tell you, he can answer the boots. In fact, I think he probably outweighs Gerald Johnson by a few pounds.
He does.
But in any case, he picked up the first down there. He's not explosive. He is big. We may see some of that as the game goes on. The first down there is the ball that goes to the 34-yard line. There's a good back to sign for. Trying to find his way around the right side. He's inside the 30 to the 48. And as you say, Gordon methodically moving the football down the field. Not with a lot of flash or a lot of big plays thus far, but they're doing what Coach Nelson Campbell wants them to do. Call it a pickup of about 6 or 7, and it will bring second, let's call it 9.